I'm picturing purple sequins and awkward swaying, and your heels are tall, but they're not like tall enough to really do super heels.
I probably rolled my ankle in this like thing too. But why?
So that's your first stripper song.
Why in the hell,
Ryan? Help.
Dude, why in the hell am I stripping to "Daughters" by John Mayer?
Well, that's what I'm saying. There might be a problem here.
I'm looking forward to the first email. I don't know if I've received it yet. We're filtering through a couple of things, but I'm looking forward to the first email of saying, I will help you for free.
You know, and take advantage of it when it happens. I'm going to encourage you to embrace that moment and reply back, yes.
As long as we do it on air.
I'm in. Yes, that too. That's another contingency.
I will say this. I have a great relationship with my father. He's a great man.
Okay.
but I don't know why I felt the need to have that dream, but it has stuck in my mind. This was probably a good 6 years ago, I gotta think. So,
did you by chance like listen to John Mayer earlier that day, or he was in something you saw, or the song was playing when you're shopping at Publix, looking at purple eggplants, maybe? I don't know. All those things combined into your brain. You fall asleep. Boom. Stripper dream.
I don't know. It just happened, and I made a lot of money that night.
Unsolved mystery. Unsolved mystery, then.
So, Cass, you go next.
Okay. So my song, I don't think I told you this, Jenny. Maybe I did. When I moved here, I was going to a couple different gyms to try to figure out like where I wanted to work out and what kind of workout I wanted. And I may or may not have taken some pole classes for the pure sanity of a good workout, which I really enjoyed. So when I'm thinking about getting on the pole as a stripper song, it has a lot to do with athleticism and what you can do with the song and what kind of emotions that invoke with like actual athletic pole moves. And this is kind of where I go with it. This is my jam here. So doing like the slow walk around, kind of get warmed
That's
up.
That's good.
Sure things are ready.
Yeah.
Kind of climbing the pole now, you know? Getting ready to do some really crazy shit. Kind of flinging your hair around, you're at the top, getting ready to like, yeah, do a little head flip. Shit gets real soon, I promise. Do you know this song?
I'm gonna need you to send it to me.
Yeah, Crave. So that's my, I guess if you listen to it longer, which I don't think we have time for, but we definitely get into some pause moments where you can really get some athletic moves going, where the legs are spinning, the ankles are by your ears, and there's techno kind of stuff going on in the background. That's my stripper song. See? Can you hear the dirty stuff going?
I love it. I love it. I love how uncomfortable Brian's like fidgeting is right now.
So uncomfortable. Here's the question. Here's the guy question. Is it like a background thing? Is it just a inner sexuality that you're like, this is how we can kind of show our sexuality, not in the stripper aspect, but just in the fact that the performance wise.
No, I think it's pretty powerful that like that they can literally work a couple of hours and just.
I know it's all about the money for you, Jenny.
I don't know. I never really. I was never in a position where I would have probably had enough confidence to go that route, but I feel like it's a profession where like, I mean, kudos to you. Like you're not, depending on the strip club, you're not leaving anything to the imagination. You're throwing yourself all in and I don't know. I don't have a problem with the industry
at
all.
I've seen, coming around to a couple different kinds of experiences I've had in different states, different areas, I've seen some really sad moments where like, you're definitely doing this to pay rent and you're not having a great time right now. I'm happy that option's there for them. I think it's empowering. I don't think they felt that same way. But I've also been like, when you go to Vegas and you see those girls that like, that is what they do.
What's the difference between that and working at McDonald's? Like,
there's the money.
Sad moments there too.
Yeah, no, I know what you mean. It's, I think for the professionals, right, that like all they do is live and breathe to get on stage and there's athleticism behind it. I admired that because there's, again, it's being someone that took a couple classes, it is really athletic and it's hard to do a lot of the things that they do, and making that kind of money while you're doing it, I think is kind of awesome. Yeah.
Well, I think the equivalent would be like opening up a Viking bar. All men want to be Vikings. That's what I'm trying to equate it to. Do all women like really? Have this fantasy of being a stripper, even though that might not be what they want to go do with their life, but it's just this fantasy of it.
I think with what you're going with that, I think all women dream of having the confidence to do that. And not necessarily like get in front of a whole bunch of people and get naked. Even if you think about, like I have some girlfriends that talked about trying to do it for their boyfriends, or their husbands at that time, their partners that they're intimate with all the time, not having the confidence to get into something small and cute and dance around the bedroom and like really have that. What movie is it where Jamie Lee Curtis tries to do it? It's really old school. True Lies, where she's in that moment where she has to like gain that confidence and gain it quick, right? Like she's not that person. But I think all women dream of being able to do that, where all of a sudden you are super sexy, you know you're owning it, and it's getting all the attention that you're hoping it gets in a positive way, not necessarily again in front of a group of people, but even in the privacy of your bedroom. I think that's what it's about, is that confidence to own your sexuality.
I definitely still want the cash flow.
I mean, it wouldn't hurt to have that. It is a pretty big perk to it.
So my next one, and as I was, Cassie doesn't know that I'm doing this one. But as I'm doing this, I get that everyone's probably over this already by now. But as we were looking for a theme song, we were listening to different songs over and over and over again. And our goal was, let's find a song that we could listen to all the time and not get over. And so that is how we came up with Toadie's Possum Kingdom. But recently I listened to it before we had recorded our first episode, and I was like, man, if I were a stripper, this would be my song. And my thought is, it's 5 minutes long. That is a long time for me to make money.
Yes. And, you know, depending on your skill set, you're going to be repeating some moves. There's going to be some awkward pauses. And maybe that's an opportunity where you like crawl the bar. So, I mean, maybe that's a benefit.
So I have this all mapped out. So I am going to, before I get on stage, I have two things on this. Before I get on stage, I am going to already have like a bachelor party picked out. I am going to have them ready to pull the guy up on stage. And then, actually, I've got probably about three minutes before that happens. And then I imagine that I will be in latex.
Good call.
I'm going to put him in a chair and put him next to the pole. And I'm going to take duct tape his arms and
that's gonna hurt the chair. Have you considered using the latex tape that doesn't stick to hair yet?
I'll do that. That's actually kind of fun. And then he's gonna be strapped to the chair. I'm gonna climb the pole. And I'm gonna kind of dance around him a little bit, and then I'm gonna climb the pole when it gets ramped up. And then I'm gonna slide down. He's gonna feel like he's gonna die.
You need a little fear in there. There's no adrenaline. What's the fun in that?
Exactly. And I'm gonna slide down the pole. Like, he's gonna be underneath me. My hair is gonna be like cascading, falling down. Mm-hmm. Yes. And I just feel like, I would have had 3 initial minutes to get money from mm-hmm. normal people and then like pull him on the stage. I have plenty of time to mm-hmm. tie him up. I already have a flat fee that I charge for bringing him on stage right. from his friends.
They pay for that.
You know, and then I feel like I would be getting more tips from the audience for completely
humiliating. So I feel like your cascading down move, what I'm picturing in my head, because like you have like the long flowing dark hair, is like, you know, when you go to the top of the bar and you got your whole body's kind of, waist down, wrapped around it so the rest of your body can be free from the pole. But you do that weird archy thing yes. that I'm not capable of doing because I have a very inflexible spine. But you do the back yes. arch thing where your hair just like suddenly becomes this weird extension towards the ground almost, where you're like perfectly like 90 degrees from the ground. You got that crazy little arch right in the center mm-hmm. of your back. Arms out, like caffeine just kicked in. Arms, like wrist to backbone kind of. Yeah.
Yep.
What I'm picturing.
Mm-hmm. In this like imagination situation, I can do all of that.
Are you wearing purple in this one?
No, this one I'm latex, but it's black. And and when you listen to the song, there are definitely a lot of times where I could be mm-hmm. crawling. It just lends itself to a lot of things. So I feel like it yeah. works out really well. Side That's interjection.
Detour.
I'm getting ready this morning and my kids run into the bathroom as they're trying to figure out what they're doing with their lives today. And I have my earbuds in and bless. I have a 5-year-old and he's learning to read. And I have my earbuds in so I can see the lyrics to try and figure out like at what point I want to play the song. Don't want to play the whole song because I don't mm-hmm. want to get in too much trouble. And he says, "Mommy, what is this?" I'm like, what are you talking about, honey? And he's like, what is this?
My blushing bright. My lover be my lover. Yeah, honey.
Don't be. Oh, my ovaries. Yeah. That's adorable.
Yeah.
Make up your mind.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes I've heard
Make
that.
Up your mind.
Yes,
Make
everybody
up your
I know.
Mind. And I'll promise you, I will treat saying. You well.
Sorry. That's what they all say.
Yeah, that's the best part.
You let your child read this.
Do you want to be my angel?
Do you want to be my angel?
You have it up to me. So this is a new way to teach your children how to read. How informational.
When he started, I was like, oh God, I'm never going to look at the song the same. And so I wanted to share that
I love it.
With you.
Yeah, we're going to get letters.
We're going to get letters. Oh God. What's that knock on the door? It's child services.
Never give away your location.
Yeah, that'd be fine. So I think, God, I know.
Yeah, I have another one actually. But I have one more that is kind of. You're probably gonna. I do. One's very cliche though, and I think every girl's thought of this as her stripper song. But like my other one, that's not as well thought of, I don't think, or considered, is more like your standard like lap dance song. I would think that's what I'm picturing. So, mm-hmm. At least I think it's like a lap dance song. Maybe I'm in my own head about it. Whoa! Nope.
Was that the Holland National Anthem? What the hell was that?
That was not it. Okay. So I can picture this as like that song that you want this guy to like really take, like in a bar if you're like slow dancing by yourself, take you home. But like this is a song that he's going to almost fall in love with you with and then fall in love with you and then kind of maybe take you back to like the champagne room, get the more money. You know what I mean? Kind of much more of an intimate song, and I think that's where if you can evoke that emotion, I think that this is something that will keep some bills flowing. And her voice, man, makes me just want to get on a pole. Like, just mesmerizing to me.
I'm so tired. I'll play.